Hi everyone! Welcome to my channel, Tutorial by Sir Raymond. My name is Mr. Jem Raymond Ischen, Master Teacher 2 from Escalante Central Elementary School, Schools Division of Escalante City, DepEd Region 6, Western Visayas. Click like and share if this video tutorial helps you. Don't forget to click subscribe below to keep updated for my future tutorial. For your suggestions, especially on the topic for my next tutorial, please leave your comment below. Hope you learned something in my video lessons for this week. Thank you so much for watching. Stay home and stay safe. Hello Grade 6, how are you today? I hope everybody is fine and safe. And welcome to our mathematics class once again. And it's checking time! We will now check the assessment and the additional activities part of your Module 3 for your Week 3 in your Mathematics 6. Let us now answer the assessment part of your Lesson 1 of your Module 3. I hope you have your copies in your answer in the assessment part of your module last time. So let us now answer your assessment. We are going to match the word phrases in column A with the numerical expressions and equations in column B. Write the letter of the correct answer in your answer sheet. Are you ready? Let's start. Number 1, a number B subtracted from 12. What is the correct translation here for this given word phrase? Yes, it's letter I. 12 minus B. Next, number 2. 6 times the number Y. Very good. It's letter A. 6Y. Number 3. The sum of 5 and thrice a number Z. Very good. It's letter C. 5 plus 3Z. Number 4. 12 divided by N. What's your answer? Very good. It's letter J. 12 divided by N. Next, number 5. 1 less than the product of 4 and Y. Very good. It's letter H. 4y minus 1. Number 6. A number Z increased by 10. What's the answer? Very good. It's letter F. Z plus 10. Number 7. Twice the square of a number X. Very good. It's letter B. 2x squared. Number 8. Thrice the product of 4 and R. Very good. It's letter G. 3 times 4R. Next, number 9. 9 times a number K. Very good. It's letter E. 9K. Number 10. 6 times a number X minus 5. Very good. It's letter D. 6X minus 5. Okay, ulitin natin yung mga sagot sa assessment part. Number 1, a number B subtracted from 12. Again, the correct answer is letter I. It's 12 minus B. Baka naguguluhan kayo. Sir, bakit nauna yung 12 number dito kaysa sa B? Eh, ang na-letter B naman yung unang ibinigay sa expression or sa word phrase. Class, take note. Ang ibig sabihin ng expression na to or ng word phrase na to ay number 1, kukunan daw ng number B ang 12. So, yung 12, yung magiging minuend mo. Yung minuend, yung number na babawasan. So, ang ibig sabihin again, sa number 1, babawasan ng number B ang 12. Okay? So, pwede natin class gamitin yung word na from as clue. Ang susunod na number sa word na from ay yung number na kukunan or babawasan ng number sa naunang sinabi sa expression. Okay? So, hindi po pwedeng B minus 12. Hindi naman sinabi dito na ang B ang babawasan, kundi ang ibig sabihin nito, ang 12 ay yung babawasan ng B. That's why the correct answer for number 1 is 12 minus B. Number 2, 6 times the number. Yes, letter A. It's 6y. Hindi na natin lalagyan yan ng x sa gitna, class, kasi gumamit na siya ng y. So kung ilalagyan pa natin ito ng x sa gitna, malamang sa malamang kayo ay malilito. Baka akalain ninyo dalawang variables na ang given sa number 2. When you combine a number and the letter, this means multiplication. Understood? Okay, very good. Number 3. The sum of 5 and tries number Z. Very good. Letter C. 5 plus 3Z. Number 4. 12 divided by N. Ano nga yung answer dito? Letter J. It's 12 divided by N. Number 5. 1 less than the product of 4 and Y. Very good. 4Y minus 1. So, ang ibig sabihin nito, ang product ng 4y ang babawasan ng 1. Okay? Because of the word less than. Number 6, a number Z increased by 10. Yes, it's letter F, Z plus 10. Number 7, twice the square of a number X. Yes, it's letter B. That's 2x squared. Number 8, thrice the product of 4 and R. Yes, it's letter G. 3 times 4R. Next, number 9. 9 times a number K. Okay, very good. Letter E, 9K. Or 9 times K. Number 10, 6 times a number X minus 5. Very good. It's letter D, 6X minus 5. I hope you got a very good score on your assessment for lesson 1 of this module. Good job! This time, let's answer the additional activities of your lesson 1 still in your module 3. I hope you are now holding your answer for this part of your module. Direction is, translate the following verbal phrases into algebraic expressions or equation. Let's have number 1. 5 subtracted from twice Z. Oh, wag balito. May clue na naman tayo dito na from. So, ibig sabihin, ang twice Z ang siyang babawasan ng 5. Diba? Oh, that's 2Z minus 5. Ang ibig sabihin again ng twice is 2, right? 2 times. So, this is 2 times Z minus 5. Number 2, a number P less 11 is 50. Very good. It's P minus 11 equals 50. Yung P na ang babawasan ng 11. Number 3, 15 decreased by a number. Very good. 15 minus P is the translation. Number 4, the square of the product of X and Y. Very good. XY squared. Number 5, the sum of 6 and 20 less 5 equals the number Z. Medyo mahaba, no? Okay, sum daw, yung sum. So, yung sum ng 6, 20. So, that is 6 plus 20 na. Para hindi ka malito, class, lagyan mo ito ng parenthesis. Ha? Pagkatapos, less. Ang ibig sabihin ng less is minus. Very good. And then 5. And then equals so, this is the correct answer. 6 plus 20 minus 5 equals Z. Letter B. Translate the following numerical expression or equations into word phrases. O, this time, kabaliktaran naman ang gagawin natin. So, number 1. Very good. It's twice a number X plus 5. Pero, possible answer lang to kasi pwede kang gumamit ng ibang mga words na associated sa addition at saka sa multiplication, right? Pwedeng sabihin din dito, the product of 2 and X added to 5. Pwede din yon. Ang isinulat ko dito is possible answer lang. Understood? Very good. Number 2 also, you can have your own answer there. As long as if you evaluate it, if it is correct. Number 2 here is, the possible answer here is 5 times a number x less 8. Okay? So, pwede ring sabihin 8 is subtracted from 5x. Pwede din ganun ang sagot mo. Okay? So, this is just a possible answer for this item. Number 3, 4 times y plus 7. Pwede din 4 times the product of y and 7. Okay? So, that's 4 times the sum of y and 7. Number 4, that's 2n equals 120. As simple as that, you can answer that way. Okay? Twice the number n equals 120 would be also one of the possible answers. Pero kung sasabihin mo 2n equals 120, correct din yun. Okay? 2 times n equals 120, pwede din yun. Okay? Number 5. 4 squared equals 16, pwede din yun. Huh? So, 4 squared equals 16. Okay? Did you get it right, class? Very good. Let's answer the assessment part of your lesson 2, still in your module 3 for Mathematics 6, quarter 3. Do you have with you your answer last time about this assessment? Okay, very good. For your assessment, write the variable used in each item below. So, it's very easy, right? Isusulat mo lang yung variable na ginamit per item. Number 1, what's your answer? The variable is? Very good, it's y. Next, number 2. Anong variable dito? Obviously, that's b. Husay naman. Number 3, anong variable na ginamit? Very good, it's letter y. Number 4, anong variable na ginamit sa item number 4? Yes, correct. It's letter N. Number 5. Very good. It's letter Z. Next, number 6. Anong ginamit na variable dito? Very good. It's letter P. Number 7. Anong variable na ginamit? Number 7 is R. Number 8. Anong variable na ginamit? Very good, it's letter X. Number 9, ano naman ang ginamit na variable sa number 9? It's Q. Very good. And the last number is letter T. Very good. Okay? I'm sure you've got a very good score in your assessment for your lesson 2. And this is about identifying the variable in the given expression and equation. Good job! This time, let us answer your additional activities in your lesson 2, still in your module 3. Now, direction, translate the following word phrases into algebraic expression or equation. We will use variables to represent the unknown number. Number 1, a number less than a quotient of 70, 5, and 15. Very good, that's 75 divided by 15. Minus n. Ang ginamit natin na variable for number 1 here is letter n. So again, pwede kang gumamit ng ibang letter sa alphabet to represent our variable in number 1. Number 2, 64 reduced by a number is 48. Reduce is? Yes, subtraction. This is 64 minus n equals 48. Again, n ang ginamit ko dito, pwede mong gamitin ang ibang letter sa alphabet para mag-represent ng number dito. Number 3, the sum of a number and 12 is 26. Very good, n plus 12 equals 26. Number 4, 17 added to a number. Correct, that's 17 plus n. Number 5, 21 added to a number. Very good, it's 21 plus n. Good job! Number 6, and decrease by 3. Ano nga yung ibig sabihin ng decrease? Anong operation ang nire-represent ng decrease na word? It's subtraction, right? So that's n minus 3. Number 7, 18 less than a number. Very good. That's n minus 18. Next, number 8, a number less thrice 15. Very good. N minus 3 times 15. Huwag malito, class. Walang than na word dito. Ang ginamit na word dito is less. Kung ang gagamitin is less than, so ang ibig sabihin yan, ang n ang babawasan sa 18. Ang dito naman, kasi wala namang than ang ginamit, less lang naman, so ang n dito ang siyang mag-stand as our minuend, and this is our subtrahend, your thrice 15. Next, number 9, 5 times a number less 3 is 18. Very good. It's 5n minus 3 equals 18. And number 10, a number added to 90 is 502. Very good. It's n plus 90 equals 502. Now count your score. What's your score? I know you've got a very good score for this additional activities. Congrats! Watch out for my next video lesson for your week 4 in your quarter 3, mathematics 6, next time. That will be the next video lesson that I will be uploading, and that would be your module 4. Watch out for that. If you want to keep updated in all my video lessons and in all my video tutorials, please do subscribe in my YouTube channel, Tutorial by Sir Raymond, or you may search Teacher Gem Raymond Chin. For those who have subscribed already, thank you so much. That's all for this week, class. Thank you so much for participating. Have a blessed week ahead. Don't forget to stay home and be safe always.